Salvete omnes. Today we're doing the second lecture in a series of lectures on Roman history. This is from Livy's work of Urbe Condita. And this will be the story where we continue about Ascanius and Aeneas' descendants. So this is titled Numitor and Amulius. All right, so after Ascanius left Lavinium, he established a town called Alba Longa. All right, and here's a picture of where Alba Longa is. There's a couple sites that they think that happened. It's around this lake called Lake Albano today. It's outside of Rome, up in the hills, in the Alban Hills. And somewhere along one of these ridges, Ascanius supposedly established a town named Alba Longa. All right. All right. The descendants of Ascanius. He ruled for many years, and then he passed along the throne to his son. And here they are. So Ascanius or Eulus, remember that the Julian family, like Julius Caesar, Augustus, and so forth, traced their descent to Venus and Aeneas through Ascanius. So Ascanius had a son named Silvinius, who means born in the woods. And then there's another, then the next person who came king was Aeneas Silvinius, Latinius Silvinius, Attis Silvinius, Captus Silvinius, Capetus, Tibernus, who supposedly drowned crossing the Albula River, which later became the Tiber. And then the next king was Agrippa, and then a guy named Romulus Civilis. All right. And then Romulus Civilis had a son named Proca. All right. The sons of Proca. Now, here's another picture. This is the palace that is a papal palace that's looking over the lake. And this is, some people think this is also a site of Alba Longa. So it's quite beautiful. I really do want to go and see it. So now Proca had two sons. And this is where we want to take some detailed notes here. Two sons named Numitor and Amulius. Proca gave Numitor, the eldest, hereditary realm of the Silvian family. So he made Numitor, or designating Numitor, as the next king. Numitor was just and wise, while Amulius was not so. However, after Proca died, Amulius drove out his brother and seized the throne. Not so good. After seizing the throne, Amulius killed Numitor's sons and made Numitor's daughter, Rhea Silvia, a Vestal virgin, so made her a priestess of Vesta. And by doing this, he was trying to ensure that Numitor would have no male descendants, because the sons are gone, and then the one daughter is made a priestess of Vesta, where you cannot marry. And then Rhea Silvia later claimed that she was raped by Mars and gave birth to twins, Romulus and Remus. The story goes that she was walking down to the river Tiber to get water for her temple. And she walked down there, and then Mars found her. Here's a mosaic, actually, of Mars and Rhea Silvia. This is found in the ancient port of Ostia, which people call today Ostia Attica. It's a mosaic, of course. Amulius, after Romulus and Remus were born, ordered that the mother be thrown in jail and the twins drowned in the Tiber. Now, they were taken out by woodsmen, servants of the king, and they were told to be thrown in the Tiber. But when they got to the Tiber was flooded, and they placed the basket not in the middle of the river, but on near the side. And what happened is the water receded because it was flooded. The twins were left on solid ground. And supposedly the spot in ancient times, there was a fig tree that stood there and you could go see it. While they were there in a basket, a wolf left from a nearby hill that later was known as the Palatine Hill and found the twins, offered her teats to suck, and took care of them. Now, this is the most famous statue that has been copied many times and found in many different places of the twins and the she-wolf. Now, this statue, many people think, goes back to the 5th century BCE, but now there's some more modern scholars think that actually comes from the 12th century CE, or from in the Middle Ages. And then the babies were added into the Renaissance. But this has become the symbol of Rome today. A shepherd, a nearby shepherd, a guy named Faustulus, found the wolf licking the twins with her tongue. So the wolf came and took care of him for a little bit, and then a local shepherd found them. Then Faustulus took the twins home and gave them to his wife, Laurentia, to take care of. Nota bene, Livy and other ancient historians think the origin of this fable comes from a nickname for Laurentia, and that's what led to her. She was called a lupa. All right, so here's a picture of Romulus and Remus sheltered by Faustulus, and this is by from the 17th century. That's really cool, by Pietro de Cortona. Just want to show you that. All right, now, as the boys grew up, they grew in strength and resolution because of their birth and upbringing, because they were the sons of a god of Mars. And then they were also in the countryside doing country things, taking care of sheep, you know, leading groups of young men in the, you know, doing all, I don't know, all the different things they did. But they grew up strong and brave and handsome. They were active herders and hunters. And they also started robbing the local thieves and sharing the loot with other shepherds. So people would, you know, if they ever found robbers, they would take stuff from them and give the loot to their friends and neighbors. Now, here's a great little etching I found by a guy named Giovanni Battista Fontana from the 1573. That's really cool. And so go ahead and put the Latin down here. It says, A Faustulo pastori educati, Romulus et Remus, Leones et Ferias, caedendo ac latrones spoliendo prima triconia faciunt. And this Latin is found along the top here and the bottom. And it has a picture of Romulus and Remus out in the countryside. Oh, you can see there's like robbers out in the back that, you know, and then they're here killing a leonem. They are necebant leonem, and doing country things, growing up strong. And I love it. It has the hills and the trees and everything like this. So write down the Latin. And I just got it from the sides. You can always stop the presentation if you need to, if you haven't finished writing it down. And the meaning that you want to make sure you know says, we have started with Romulus and Remus, which are your nominative, educati, having been raised, a Faustulo pastore, by the shepherd Faustulus, Leones et Ferias, that's accusative. Now, what do they do? By caediendo ac, by killing lions and wild beasts, and also by spoliando latrones, by robbing robbers, they made their first triconia, their first training. So they were doing, that's what they were raised doing. They made their first training. So it's pretty cool. All right, we'll go ahead, look at the next one. So things were going well for them. They were growing up big and strong. And then we came to the festival of the Lupercalia. And the Lupercalia is held in ancient Rome, or was held in ancient Rome around the middle of February. And so they were going to celebrate this festival that was also being held in Alba Longa. Rome does not exist right now, of course. The Happy Festival of Lupercalia was held on the Palatine Hill, which got its name from the Acadian Evander, who held a settlement there called Palentium. So they were out celebrating the Lupercalia. And Lupercalia was an annual festival in honor of the Lycian Pan. Men would run around naked and to sport themselves in various pranks and fooleries. To sport is to enjoy oneself unrestrainedly, frolic. They would go around, and many historians and scholars today think it was a way to like get rid of evil, as a way to cleanse the city. And so Romulus and Remus were doing this. And those robbers who they'd been not treating so well and taking their stuff decided they're going to get revenge upon Romulus and Remus. So on the day of the Lupercalia, the brigands or the robbers laid a trap. Romulus was able to defend himself from the brigands, but Remus was captured. Remus was then brought to the king of Alba Longa, their great uncle, Amulius, the evil king. And the robbers, the brigands, complained that the twins were leading a gang of ruffians on cattle raids. They're saying, hey, these guys, Romulus and Remus, were taking cattle, which was a big deal in ancient times. Now, Numitor was still around. And since these raids were on Numitor's lands, Amulius sent Remus to Numitor for judgment. So he didn't have a family, but he still had some lands to support himself. All right, the truth comes out. Faustulus suspected the boys were of royal blood, but feared that if the truth came out, Amulius would kill the boys. So Faustulus at this time decided to take the matter into his own hands. Faustulus thought it was time to tell Romulus the truth. At the same time, Numitor took looking at Remus and hearing and seeing that his character was so different from the lowly born, figured out that Remus was his grandson. So Faustulus told Romulus, and then Numitor's like, oh, Remus, there's two twins. This is the right age, blah, blah, blah. Here we go. Everyone figured out what was going on. Here's a cool mosaic from England, from Leeds, from the third, somewhere between like 300 to 400 of the Common Era. So this is really cool showing, I like the wolf here, with you have Romulus and Remus down here, and then this is the fig tree, maybe, perhaps? Pretty cool. So I just want a little art here to talk about. All right. So Numitor, Romulus, and Remus decided to lead a surprise attack and kill Amulius, and they were successful. They said, we're going to go out and get the evil king and restore Numitor to the throne. And they got all their people together and did so. Afterwards, they held a public meeting to tell the people the truth about what had happened. The crowd cheered them and confirmed the royal status of Romulus and Remus. Afterwards, Numitor was restored as king of Alba Longa. Romulus and Remus left, however, to find a new settlement. They decided not to stay at Alba Longa, but to go out and find a new settlement. I wonder what settlement they will go establish. All right, last slide here. It's another little woodcut by Giovanni Battista Fontana from 1573. And it shows here, I think this right here, the person in the middle here is Numitor, and you have Romulus and Remus, and everyone's coming together, and they're going to tell everyone what is happening. And the Latin that's on the side, which you want to write down, is Amulio Caeso Numitor populo arma in Romulum moventem pacato Albane regno restituitur. So we have here Amulio Caeso, this nice little ablative absolute, with Amulius having been killed, Numitor, and then you go all the way down here, was restored. And then we have some more ablative absolutes afterwards. So he was restored to the throne. And then you have the people moving weapons against Romulus. So they want to go and fight against Romulus because they killed Amulius. But Numitor is like, I'm going to stop them from that from happening. And then so with the people, Moente moving arms against Romulus, and then Pacato Albi Regno, with the kingdom having been pacified at Alba Longa. And there we go. All right. Valete omnes lingua latina est vita.